it's a sort of hotel, of course, and there are people there for the year, for the academic year, invited by the management. And Robert and a couple of senior members. And Robert favored formalism. He had a very different set of criteria for judging things from Viki's. He was very impressed with the relativistic methods of calculation that Dick Feynman had developed and Stückelberg. Schwinger's method was quite clumsy, although it was covariant, it was quite clumsy, and I think nobody's ever used it except Schwinger and his students. But the Stückelberg-Feynman method was very useful. And Robert was impressed with the formalism that went with deriving it. Feynman, of course, had his own derivation, which was perfectly adequate. It wasn't very elegant. Freeman Dyson had a sort of a sketch of a derivation that he published, and he impressed Robert enormously. Why, I never really understood, but Robert was very enthusiastic about Freeman. And I couldn't see that he had contributed very much except to make the derivation slightly better.
The derivation here, do you mean renormalization scheme?
No, the derivation, of Dick Feynman's
of the rules.
Yeah, or the Stückelberg rules, yeah. Whichever you want to call them. And the other thing that Freeman did was to give a very, very crude sketch of how to renormalize to all orders, but it was extremely crude. It was improved and turned into a real proof by Salam and Matthews in a paper that I think was 140 pages long, and by John Ward in a letter that was maybe 20 lines long. Graham should be delighted that John Ward was then at Oxford and Salam and Matthews at Cambridge.
Did you know Ward, incidentally?
Oh, Ward, I knew Ward extremely well. He came to the Institute, and I saw a lot of him, and I knew him very, very well.
What was the atmosphere like there? I mean,
yeah, so they were, anyway, what I was going to say was that the atmosphere was rather peculiar, because Robert invited a lot of people who had done formal things that somewhat resembled the formal method for deriving the Feynman rules in Dyson's manner. So lots of people who had fiddled with wiggly surfaces and so in space-time, wiggly space-like surfaces in space-time, and various other things. Olivier Costa de Beauregard. Le Comte Olivier Costa de Beauregard, who had played with positrons as electrons going backwards in time. In other words, anyone who had done anything formal that vaguely resembled these advances in formalism that Stückelberg and Feynman had accomplished was invited there. Well, these people were not very creative, most of them. They had done some little bit of formalism on, for example, on wiggly space-like surfaces, mm-hmm. but they were not really doing much in the way of physics. There were a few people who were very interested in physics and were very clever. I was there during two academic years because I spent the calendar year 51, so I actually met two sets of people, which was very nice.